بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه. ان شاء الله we will start a new series here at Al-Aqsa Mosque, الحرم الشريف, reading from another book of Imam Al-Ghazali رحمه الله, which is منهاج العابدين, the path of worshippers. And of course there is a longer title, منهاج العابدين إلى جنة رب العالمين, the path of worshippers to the paradise of the Lord of the worlds. And I'm not going to speak about the life of Imam al-Ghazali except a very brief introduction, setting the context for this book, which is practically when Imam al-Ghazali returned to Tus Khurasan. When he returned to Tus Khurasan after a life which is alhamdulillah full with scholarship, he was prolific, and he treaded on the path of the hereafter. He abandoned his job at the Nizami of Baghdad. He distributed his wealth. And of course, he wanted to cleanse his heart. And after he returned to Tus Khurasan, he lived for a few years. And obviously, from the introduction, we know that he wanted to summarize everything, just simply to put a new book, which would capture really everything that he found and that he thought necessary for the future generations. And he prayed that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would give acceptance to this book. He said in the Arabic text, you will find that there is a certain introduction by one of the students of Imam al-Ghazali, who wrote this book directly from the dictation of Imam al-Ghazali. I'll just mention the Arabic and then we'll just go back to the English text. This is the extra one. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وبه نستعين. قال الشيخ الفقيه الصالح الزاهد عبد الملك ابن عبد الله رضي الله عنه أملى علي الإمام الأجل الزاهد الموفق حجة الإسلام زين الدين شرف الأئمة محيي الأمة أبو حامد محمد بن محمد بن محمد الغزالي رضي الله عنه هذا الكتاب, وهو آخر كتاب صنفه ولم يلتمس منه إلا الخواص من أصحابه. So in this brief introduction that is a bit extra, a student of Imam al-Ghazali, عبد الملك بن عبد الله, said that Imam al-Ghazali dictated this book directly. He praised Imam al-Ghazali's work, and he said that this book is the last book that Imam al-Ghazali wrote. So we can, it is fair enough to say that this book will reflect really the wisdom that Imam al-Ghazali found in his search for indubitable knowledge and in pleasing the heart. So Imam al-Ghazali said, rahimahullah, in the name of God, the most compassionate, the most merciful, praise belong to God, the King, the wise, the bountiful, the generous, the almighty, the boundlessly merciful, who created man of the best stature, في أحسن تقويم, and we understand that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the human being in this perfect, though we know that it is imperfect, in the best possible fashion. So Imam al-Ghazali is reflecting on this issue, and the Imam, to my knowledge, he will never write something, not a sentence, not a phrase, except that he wants to send a message. And for us, this is a very powerful thing in Islam. The human being did not evolve from dead matter. The human being did not evolve, so the whole story of the Darwinian revolution is dead wrong, really. Not only how could a universe that was born sterile with a temperature that we cannot even imagine what it means, when there were no atoms, no neutrons, no protons, no electrons, and then there is life. It has to be Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Who begat the heavens and the earth by his power, he ordered the affairs of this world and the next by his wisdom, and created not the jinn and man except for his worship. وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. The path is clear for the determined travelers, and the proof is unambiguous for those who contemplate. However, it is God alone who guides whom he wills. And strays whom he wills. And he knows best for those who are guided. The end of this introduction is very clear in about the clear path. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam showed us, he told us that one day he drew a line, and next to it parallel lines, and he said this is the straight path, but along this straight path there will be other paths that will misguide people. الصراط المستقيم واضح ولكن هنالك إلى جانبه طرق أخرى, طرق ضلال, طرق ضلال شيطانية. Then Imam Al-Ghazali, of course, he already used the word minhaj. Which is the title really of this book. He called it Minhaj al-Jannah in Arabic, though the English translation might not capture this. Blessings upon the master of the messengers and upon all of his pious and virtuous progeny. May he give them peace and exalt them until the day of doom. And obviously, there is something missing from the English translation, which is the, of course, here, peace and salutations upon the Prophet ﷺ and his family. The English translation is short of the Arabic. The Arabic includes salutations that would include the companions of the Prophet. That would include the companions of the Prophet. And it is missing. It is missing. Salaam. And there's something in my heart, really, because it's missing, and regarding the Sahaba radiallahu anhum. No, my brothers, may God grant you and me felicity in his pleasure, that worship is the fruit of knowledge, the ultimate gain to be derived from one's life, the harvest of the strong slaves of God, and the endowment of the friends of God, the awliya. It is the path of the God-fearing, the lot of the noble, the goal of the spiritually resolved, the mark of the munificent, the vocation of real men, of men, but real men, the ultimate choice of the possessors of insight, and the path of felicity and heaven. Says God Most High, he uses in the translation an archaic language, saith, and I am your Lord, so serve me. وأنا ربكم فعبدون. And he says, behold, this is a recompense for you, and your striving is thanked. إن هذا كان لكم جزاء وكان سعيكم مشكورا. We reflected on the path of worship and its principles from the beginning to the end, wherein lies the wishes of the seekers. We found it a path of extreme difficulty, filled with many obstacles and hardships, with dreadful and long valleys, and with many afflictions and hindrances. Life cannot be without difficulties. Life cannot be without difficulties. You have been blessed with so many things, but you are going to face challenges in this life. And these challenges could be, for example, financial challenges. And these challenges could be social challenges, in terms of relationship with people. They could be political challenges, like falling under occupation. It could be sickness. It could be a disease. So life, you cannot go through this life, a blessed life, inshallah, without really facing one thing or the other. But there are blessings. Imam al-Ghazali says, it should be. Imam al-Ghazali says, it should be. It should be with difficulties. It should be with hardships. It should be with challenges. And inshallah, when we, during the next lecture in Arabic, we will speak about this for a minute or two.
الصفحة الأولى من البقرة.
And so it is meant to be, for such is the path to heaven. And this is amazing. If you know that the path to heaven is paved with challenges, with difficulties, you would accept. You try to iron things if you can, but at the same time you'll accept whatever is the case. If, for example, if it's an occupation, then you need to change that. But I mean, if it's really a financial difficulty, then you need to work. But say that you have been subjected to, you got infected with a virus. That's it. You don't complain. If there is medicine, you seek medicine, medical treatment. But otherwise, you will be, your heart should be in a state of tranquility. Then Imam Ghazali mentions the hadith. We will reflect on this. As the Messenger, peace be upon him, said, verily the path to heaven is surrounded by many deceiving plots, and the path to hell is surrounded by many passions and desires. And beware, indeed paradise is situated on high ground, and hell is on smooth ground and easy to reach. هذا الحديث إن الجنة حفت بالمكاره وإن النار حفت بالشهوات. ألا وإن الجنة حزن بربوة، ألا وإن النار سهل بسهوة. أما الحديث الأول إن الجنة حفت بالمكاره وإن النار حفت بالشهوات فهو حديث متفق عليه، رواه البخاري ومسلم. So the first hadith is agreed upon, narrated by البخاري and Muslim. The second hadith has a weak chain of narrators because someone in the chain of narrators, his name is Nuh, son of Abi Maryam, and he has another name, Yazid bin Ja'una. So this hadith has a weak chain of narrators, but nevertheless, usually we talk about the understanding. The hadith is saying that paradise is uphill. That's the to capture the essence of the hadith. The hadith is saying paradise, Jannah, is uphill. You need to go uphill. And وَلَيَذُ بِاللَّهِ hellfire is in a flat area. It means that it's not that difficult to go to hellfire, وَلَيَذُ بِاللَّهِ. The path to hellfire is very, very easy. Don't you see that some people might say a word that will anger Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And the result will be hellfire. It is easy to do business that is haram. It is rather challenging to do halal, except nowadays. I'm sorry, especially nowadays. Those who go to climb the Himalayas mountains, Mount Everest. Some that reflects basically people in general. Some people are happy to make it to base one. And some people will just continue until basically they go up Mount Everest. The reward is higher by going up the mountain. I'm not calling for endangering oneself, but I'm simply giving an example how some people are satisfied with one stage. Some people do not go to the Himalayas at all. They hear about the mountains. They see a picture of the mountains. We can't see the paradise ourselves. We can picture paradise. State of felicity, of happiness, ultimate happiness. In this life, we have moments of happiness, but in the hereafter, it's different. If you go to paradise, and inshallah you will, all of us will, inshallah. All of the ummah of Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. There is nothing that will annoy you. There is no more disease, no more difficulty, no more challenges. It's simply a state of felicity, of happiness. And those who make it to hellfire, aliyadu billah, there is no happiness at all. There's not even one single moment of joy. Not even one drink in an eternal life in hellfire that will quench their thirst, such as water. They will ask the people of paradise, give us some of the water, and they will not basically have it. So this life is mixed. This life is mixed, but not the hereafter. Either a pure state of happiness or a pure state of misery and punishment. Along with all these obstacles and challenges upon the earth, the traveler is weak. The traveler, us, don't you see when we travel? Don't you see that when we travel between one city and the other, we start complaining the seat, whether the seat is in a bus or an aeroplane, we complain that the seat is not comfortable. After a while, if you sit for long, you'll start having some pain. you will complain one way or the other because we are weak. It's not because the seat is uncomfortable. In this life, you are going to have difficulty. Point. The traveler, you and I, who is the traveler? We are the travelers. كرجل استظل تحت ظل شجر, like a human being. What's this life? Someone who's traveling and he took basically a break, sat in the shade of a tree, and then he got up, and that's it. This life is like sitting under a tree for a short while. We are weak. The time is hard. And the affairs of religion are many. Time is too short and preoccupations too many. Of course, the average, I'm not going to give advertisement to an American, a Canadian professor. He said that the average university student spends around 7-8 hours every day on his or her gadgets, on the iPhone, on the, whether it's a cell phone or basically a smartphone, that is, an iPad. It's not smart at all. We should be, but that's the issue. You waste 7-8 hours every day. You spend, that's wasting. I doubt that they are basically reading. Of course you do. I'm not denying this. But those students, when they spend 7-8 hours, if you spend 7-8 hours sleeping and then 7-8 hours, you know, basically you left nothing for the affair that Imam al-Ghazali says. Life is short. Life is short. Time is limited. The whole book of Minhaj al-Abidin, this whole book, is about giving you a chance to do the most important things in this life, in this short life. Especially, it's never too late, but especially for older people like us. There are young people. But to catch up, you need to do the essentials. You need to do that which is very important for the hereafter. You have made your millions and billions. Stop it. Enough is enough. You have made enough for a comfortable life. Tend to your hereafter. Start doing something beautiful. Something that is for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Take care of the needy, of the orphans. Start building hospitals and clinics and libraries and schools and infrastructure for the public good. But the intention should be for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Life is short. Deeds are imperfect. And we know because deeds are imperfect, we tend to do the nawafil, the extra deeds, the acts of worship, so that we compensate for the shortcomings, for the imperfections. We pray the fard, and then we pray extra to make up for any shortcomings. We fast Ramadan, and then we fast other days to make up. We give the zakah, which is obligatory. Then we give some sadaqah to make up. Make up for what? Maybe you did not give the zakah in the most beautiful fashion. Maybe your heart was aching because you are giving money. Walayadu billah. Forgetting that it is from Allah and to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Insha'Allah, on Saturday, بإذن الله عز وجل, we'll catch up with the rest of maybe, or at least the beginning of the second lecture, insha'Allah, of Minhaj al-Abidin. Subhanakallah wa hamdik. Nashhadu ala anta astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.